Good morning and welcome to our breakfast interview today. Now, let me ask you a question. Do you belong to a political party? And when is the last time you participated in the activities of that party? Whether it's an election or whether it's a political activity of that political party? Now, the state of our political parties in this country is in quite disarray, if you ask. Many parties haven't held elections. Many of them have officials who are interim, and they're not holding annual meetings as expected or required of their constitutions. The function of the Center for Multiparty Democracy is to deepen democracy and establish democratic practice in this country. We haven't heard much from them, but today, the chairman of the CMD, Honorable Omingo Magara, is with us to talk about CMD and the state of our democracy. Karibu, Mheshimiwa.
Thank you.
I can see you're looking healthy, Bana, despite being out of parliament.
Well, sometimes it's good to have a break because in politics you never have any holidays.
Yes.
So when your electorate gives you a break, it's actually a necessary holiday, which I'm enjoying and bouncing back soon. Because in politics also you withdraw strategically for scientific attack.
So yes. We're coming. So you are in strategy mode.
Yes, I'm
strategizing. Now let's look at the CMD. What is happening with the CMD? Maybe for people don't know about CMD, first of all, what is it? And then we get into how it's functioning in the performance of politics.
CMD is a Center for Multiparty Democracy, a civil society organization registered about 10 years ago. The essence of that society or group is to ensure that democracy is deepened, as you rightly put it, and that we guard it. Because remember, 10 years ago, we were almost like in a dictatorship state where a few parties were running, and that was the necessity now coming up and agitating for multipartism, pluralism, alternative view, and therefore CMD was registered about 10 years ago. What we do usually is to ensure that the gains so far attained by agitators of multipartism or democracy is not shrunken again back to the dark ages.
Right.
Of course, you know that in power games, anything that comes new is threatening to anybody who has the status quo.
Yes.
And I can tell you, we say let's be practice democracy, but when we get there, you want to eliminate those ones who put you there.
Yes.
So we are out there to check and say, are you practicing what you preached before you got power?
Of course, you are not the ones charged with supervising. You're not the prefect of political parties.
Yes.
You are the voluntary organization of all these political parties.
Correct.
But you must have some insights into the state of our political parties, which I would like you now to venture into. How are we doing? How is the health of our political parties?
We do, but maybe before I get there, let me tell you the composition.
Yes.
CMD brings together all political parties that qualify by our definition to be in that center.
Yes.
And for example, today, we keep on changing the rules of engagement because we're also changing the new constitution and all. If you're five members of county assembly or one member of parliament, one senator or one women rep or one governor or one president, you qualify to be in the center. Therefore, out of the 56 or 59 political parties registered, we are patronizing 29 of them. And those ones not in the center have one outfit equivalent to a political party called the forum, where they also bring three members to the center to represent those ones who are outside the assembly, so that everybody else is...
So 29 plus one forum is what the CMD membership is.
So far, currently as we stand. And basically, as we rightly put it, we are not in charge of patronizing political parties, but we flag out issues that compromise democracy.
Yeah.
And for sure, we make it from an informed position and a well-researched position so that we kind of guard and expose the negatives that we're gaining and agitate for the positives that we must grow to.
What is the advantage of being a member of the Center for Multiparty Democracy as a political party?
As a political party, we have...
And they have to pay in with the members?
Yes. The membership... kind of society where you pay annual subscription of 50,000 shillings, and most members actually pay up because there are benefits that come with it. When you get support from development partners, we actually build capacity of political parties in terms of management of the offices of political parties. We also train administration of political parties in their own setup. We have programs that we run in counties, youth programs, so that we tell them, young men, it is not about fighting for your guy out there. Yes. When they after elections, we must get together and upbeat the nation. That's why, more often than not, it provides an antidote of the heightened political temperatures at the end of elections. We bring in the PNUs, the TNA, the URP, and ODM into the same forum. And that's why when we express ourselves, we do find out what it is that you talk about. And then when we engage, we actually make decisions and consult.
Talking about speaking out, you don't speak out much. And I would think there are quite a few issues that would require your voice and your mouth out here, but it's not hard.
We have spoken.
If you look at, well, the management of political parties, there's a lot going on, capacity issues, rifts within those political parties, threats to members to punish so and so. There is a little exercise of democracy going on around. But
maybe you don't also say speak every time on anything.
Yes.
But if I can take you back, we stood by the media when they were being gagged. We have stood for devolution against those ones who think we must reverse the gains. We have actually, in essence, spoken majorly on topical issues that affects this nation. What we have actually not come out with is the position on referendum or no referendum. You realize that is a fairly divisive issue that splits the country down the middle.
Yes.
And we have actually had two meetings to agree on a position to take. Yes. But so far, we haven't agreed. In which case, you cannot, therefore, pronounce yourself on CMD unless all of us are in consensus. But that does not deprive me as a party leader of PDP to speak about what PDP stands for in respect to the national issues.
On that matter of referendum, don't you think it would have been appropriate to, especially these disparate voices out here, to actually create the forum for negotiating and discussing this divisive issue?
Actually, we have offered
CMD would be the best place.
We have offered ourselves really to offer the solution, or rather mediate this kind of process. In fact, by 15th of this month, we are moving in to talk to various actors in those three fronts where people are talking about referendum, so that we find out what is that you're agitating for. Sometimes what we lack in this nation is people want to be antagonistic. So that if we find out what the MCAs want, look at what the Senate governors want, and what Okoa Kenya wants, we can actually provide a solution. I can tell you, the issues that we require are fairly mutual, but it's only that if you take it as Makali, I'll develop withdrawal syndrome because I don't feel like I feel you right.
Yes.
So if it's Shibuya Njau here talking about it, I say, yeah, but who does he represent? But if we find a platform which you intend to create by mid-month October, we want to reach out to the I mean, it was even fair to let even dust settle, to feel even the issues they're raising because you never knew what they were. Mm. Remember initially when this issue came up, nobody was involved. It was like, pop, here we are. But then you can't move into a trade before you collect facts and speak from a strike position.
I'm surprised to hear that CMD has been there for 10 years.
Yes.
You yourself have not been there since 2013?
I was selected in end of June 2013.
So roughly a year.
So 10 years. Mm-hmm. What has CMD been doing?
Oh,
because the CMD, you say you build capacity, you get money from donors and whatever. But you can see political parties in this country are not there.
First, let me say this.
They're not there.
Let me say this, Mutagi.
They are there just for elections.
Let me say this, Mutagi. Our success story about CMD is that we, the center, was at the heart of the consumer banking process. Actually, if there were gains, most of them were attained through the center for material democracy, because that's where we had a platform of people sharing views, and we could reach out to all actors to present our agenda. We actually participated heavily on negotiating or highlighting to people the need to have peaceful elections after 2007. And indeed, if you see our publications and the media messages before elections, that was a success story. We actually have moved to support the marginalized to also participate in leadership, including women and the youth. Through our center, about five ladies who are sponsored and supported with the capacity to come to the assembly. Mm-hmm. So, and many other issues, including negotiating situations of what should our youth do in between elections. And that's why I can tell you, it's not about even democracy, but anytime democracy is threatened, we stand firm. And that has been, even the gains we've had so far, Mutegi, it has been through the civil society. Maybe you are unsung heroes.
But what I'm saying is this. Mm-hmm. What is the definition of political party in this country? It is there only elections. After elections, in fact, it's not there.
What Mutegi is saying is, what can we celebrate since the passage of the new constitution and the provisions there for entrenching political parties, entrenching multipartism in the constitution, the ethos of practice of that democracy, including political funding being provided in the constitution. We have done all that we can to actually grow political parties. What is your report?
Somehow, we give with one hand Mutegi, Makari, and we take with the other. For example, the issues of management of political parties, I think, is one thing. Let's appreciate the fact. Because most political parties are actually, right to put it, vehicles for electioneering period. And as soon as elections are over, sometimes we close shop. In fact, if you looked at some media adverts sometimes in one of the newspapers, a major political party without mentioning names, 2 weeks after elections, their offices were actually up for rental. And you could see XYZ party headquarters, the premises are out for rentals. What are we saying? The business is done, therefore we can go take a break. We agree we are a young democracy, but I think we also are not disciplined. Most of our political parties, as much as we give ideologies about them, if you look at almost of our manifestos, it's actually a cut and paste. Granted, we are growing. But what we try to do in terms of growing this democracy is detaching the political parties with the big man syndrome by providing political party funding, so that if I am a leader of a political party, I am not the alpha and omega because I'm funding it, and therefore I must dictate the tune.
Yes.
But that particular element of funding of political parties now again has been taken away by specific provisions in the Political Parties Act, Article 25,
yes,
that before you qualify to continue registration, you must have attained 5% of the total votes cast. And the 5%, Mutegi and Makali, includes the presidential vote, right? And therefore, you find today only three political parties are going to be funded. Let's be honest with ourselves. Most of our political parties have a tribal or a regional base, tribal.
Yeah.
So that if therefore you are a majority and you earn 5%, the robots are not here. The marginalists are not here. The smaller communities will never rank.
But then that's the whole point, that everybody should struggle to exile beyond their community.
Not to reproduce to get 5%. Now, the other analogy is this. If you didn't have a presidential candidate and you're in a coalition, you are 5% of a party that never had a presidential candidate has a vote in that political party which has got a presidential candidate. So when they get there, you are cut off because you're not in that party, because the presidential candidate votes are all counted in that particular party where he stood with. Now, what are we saying? The father has gotten food, the children must not eat. Unless you are saying each political party must therefore produce a presidential candidate. So we are saying, under Article 38 of the Constitution, we have a right to politic and associate ourselves.
Yes.
When you tell me I'm going to politic with conditionalities, then you are taking it away from me. That's why the Majanja ruling, when we went to quote about this, Article 25 of the Political Parties Act, Section 2, we actually in the Court of Appeal. But we are not pursuing the Court of Appeal ruling so that we get money legally. We're also pursuing the legal aspects where we want that law to be amended to be constitutional, because Article 25 of the Political Parties Act is against Article 38 of the Constitution, because you're now saying democracy is for the excluded few.
So, for example, are you saying that everybody who sets up a political party should be funded? Or
never.
What is your threshold?
It. Far from it.
Yeah.
You must not set a political party, put in a corner in Sika and Gwane or whatever.
And have some kiosks in 24 constituencies, counties.
Yes.
And then you
and
say,
then you say give me funding. There's a qualification that you must participate in elections.
Yes.
And there must be also growth towards that. The Political Parties of 2007 Act was providing that if you participate in elections and you're registered within that election period, because after elections, if you register, you can't qualify for funding. And if you didn't participate in elections, you didn't qualify for funding. So if you participate and you're showing growth, surely you must grow. How else do you grow if, therefore, some people are given fertilizer and you are denied?
You're wilting.
Yeah.
So how do you, the dilemma here is, how do you fund initiatives, or how do you appreciate effort and punish non-performance?
You know,
if a political party is established, this year has nothing, it doesn't grow, We keep funding it for how long?
No. Far from it. I'm saying there should be also provisions that all of us start from the same platform.
So there should be a basic retainer for every political party.
Not necessarily. unless because you are registered for purpose of participating in an election.
Yes.
Usually, first year you have not participated. Second year you have not participated. Do you qualify? But you will find like there are political parties who qualify. They are members in the assembly, and yet you are going to be registered for not qualifying to run 24 offices in the counties because you don't have funding. How then do you expect those members to be loyal to you? You're actually nowhere. So therefore, they are let loose. Political discipline will go to the West, and therefore, those members are going to be errant out there. We are saying, if you participate and your members,
yes,
for you to be able to oversee the growth of that party, for them also to be whipped to participate and grow the party, because also members contribute to political parties, we need to exist. What we are saying is, Mutegi and Makali, we also need to set basic standards. Surely, if you are investing 3-4 years and your kiosk is not giving you returns, you close shop. That's good business economics.
Yes, sir.
So, but before you start year one after the new constitution, you are being closed. I mean, the same line, the bar is closed, and excluding making a few grow. Actually, the ruling of Majanja was unconstitutional to the extent of Article 38.
Opponents of political party funding,
yes,
however, whichever, wherever, is that, look, why should that is taxpayers' money. Mm-hmm. Why should it be used to fund some political initiative? I don't belong to it. Mm-hmm. I don't benefit from its activity. Why should I fund an activity that has no, that's why the responsibility of formation of a political party and its growth to visibility to be recognized and deserve funding should belong to the members or initiators of that political party.
Correct.
That is the argument.
The argument is correct, but I'm saying
they can even come to Rotary where I'm a club member and fund it. If you are going to fund things,
which are public interest.
Let me say this: political parties are a source of governance. And I'm saying, and that's why actually in CMD, we intend to develop a leadership institute that brings up qualities that if you pick from a leadership pocket, you're sure you're getting a leader. Because sometimes when you put in garbage, you get out garbage.
Okay.
We're saying political parties are properly structured. Nominations properly done. Officers are running properly.
Yeah.
Secretary generals know what to do with the political parties. We actually do manage our parties through the organs that are already established, and they also nodded towards that. It is through these political parties, Makali, that we get government to create an environment of good investment. Now, you're investing in creating an environment of governance. That's where this of funding is, because all of us pay taxes, right? And when you take a soda, however poor you're paying VAT for it.
Okay.
Now, we are saying for you to, therefore, for that continuity of that governance, you need a proper system of governance, which is comes from political parties. If political parties are properly managed and governed, you can have really good quality input for good quality.
Now let's look at the results.
What we are saying, my concern is this. Look at those parties that and presidential candidates.
Yes.
The losers, their own political parties, Emmy Martha Karua, Peter Kenneth,
Dida.
Where are those parties now?
Let me say this. I think
you are talking about those, not the small. What about those? Where are they? Or even PNU? Why is PNU?
Bakali, the truth of the matter is this.
Yes.
The one I think great speakers talked about the fertility and the mortality rate of political parties is highest in the Republic of Kenya.
Yes.
Because I think in the back of my mind, we do not form them with ideologies. Frankly, I mean, let's also own up. Because part of good leadership is owning up where you think there's a mistake. So when political parties are formed, people don't go there get an ideology and get a focused position of what they want to take in the country, but they want to take power. So that as we grow our democracy, I think it's incumbent upon us to make sure that we sustain institution of governance of political parties so that you don't do it for now and close shop. Some members now who feel they are safer in having political party funding as opposed to others out there, I warn them. Because don't make laws that are convenient to you when you have power. I have laws which also can benefit you when as of power and power.
Mm.
For example, PNU, the present party,
yes,
doesn't have one MCA.
The last governing party does not exist.
Does not have one MCA. So if you are sitting pretty and saying TNA is the best party to be or URP, today, for example, without necessarily casting aspersions, one of the bigger ones can also be small.
Yes.
And you surely be in the same position. I remember some members of presidential candidates who are saying we don't want briefcase parties. Today they are briefcase. What are we saying? Please insulate yourself when you are power, and make sure you have you give out power to somebody who your enemy.
Let me ask you. Let me ask you a pessimist question.
Yes.
Given our history, the reality, it is that even those we have funded in the past are already dead. So what are we investing in? If we invest in parties that are going to be there for 3 years, they die. What is the funding for? If it's not to groom capacity, what is the oldest party in this country now?
The mistake again,
KANU.
Is this, eh?
But how many?
When we said we need to detach political parties from one-man show, it was for reason of bringing in funding that will detach the big man from the office. So when he dies, the party does not die. What have we done today? Is a big tribe or the big regions with the big parties. What does that mean? If they are not there today, there is no the party is not existing. What are we saying? We wanted to have institutions of governance of political parties that live beyond Omingo, live beyond Mutegi, and live beyond you.
And that is the question now. If you use PNU an example,
yeah.
PNU was the main party. Mm-hmm. Well, the leader moved on. Where is the party? If indeed we are investing in institutions,
exactly.
They moved with our institutions and the equipment and tools and spoons. So where are our spoons that we invested in political funds?
That this also, infantry stage of this growth.
Yes.
Believe you me, our democracy is young. The only thing that we do usually is to compare ourselves with the best.
Okay.
Even you don't compare yourself with a grandfather who have been there for over years. These are some of the issues we need to, using the act that we formulated, let's now shape at that and plug those loopholes by having a good law.
Yes.
That then covers even the members of political parties. Today, a member can actually take a political party to court. And you lose because that big man syndrome is not necessarily the panacea or solution problem solver. Mm-hmm. So the laws we are making should make sure that we insulate that one man. That's why the political party, it says you must not have a party that members come from one tribe.
Yes.
Or where the
and
man
funding,
hands.
You know, but how much percentage of funding should not come. Those are restrictions within the political parties.
Yes. Is there any way of ensuring that the parties we funded, the parties that we have funded, we account for them and make sure that they don't die?
Yes, it's possible. You know how? We have the register of political parties. A constituent office is supposed to operationalize. As we speak today, it is not. Why? The political parties, register of political parties must be superintending on the running of political parties.
Yes.
So that if they are properly in office,
yes,
surely some of these issues you are crying over will be kind of plucked.
Now, that's the crux of the matter.
Correct.
Why haven't we sorted out the political parties registrar? We have had Lucy Ndungu, whatever her name is. She never speaks, never comes out.
Why?
No, she is in acting capacity.
Why is
she's been acting since 2010, three years.
Yes.
Why?
Let me say this. There were amendments of the political parties, register of political parties, which was amended. And finally, the buck now stops with the president. In fact, Center for Multiparty Democracy has written an open letter to the president asking him to initiate the creation of that office. Because now, as we speak, Madam Lucy Ndungu is an acting capacity. She actually almost works under IEBC, which is actually an anomaly. So she's supposed to be independent with about two deputies and the many other officers that runs down the counties to be able to manage this process. So we have written a letter to the president asking him to initiate, because the parliament actually lets that, after the amendment, this matter was pushed to the Public Service Commission. The time lapsed. The act came to parliament. It was amended and left to the president now to initiate by appointing a select committee to roll out the process.
But knowing the history of the history of political parties in this country, do you think the president or the deputy president or those politicians in top there are interested in strong political parties? The only person who was interested in a strong political party, which he used very well, was President Moi.
Yeah.
When you look at Kenyatta let KANU die, and Anyona and Shikuku said he's dead for Putin.
Mm-hmm.
Now, even now today, when you look at PNU is dead. LDP dead. The others also after TNA is where is what is TNA? TNA is on air, it's only there because the president is the president.
Let me say this.
So
the question you asked earlier,
there's no political will to make strong political parties in this country. According to our history,
you could be right to some extent, but I believe that the constitutional provisions and you people in media need to help us. Because if somebody, a leader, is not playing to the rules, either by law or constitution, they need to be exposed. Maybe what we require is us to also partner with you and share you that information. So as we speak out there, maybe we're not covered, you can also highlight that matter. Because I believe even if you didn't want it, times have changed. You cannot sit in the same spot, have your cake and eat it, because times have truly changed. If you can help us agitate for that, because whoever doesn't want it, you find like change will sweep you down. The other problem is this, even if you wanted to ship me out and have a strong, you know, regional base, I'll still be relevant whichever way I go. We also need to now, in terms of capacity building and training, tell our people that the best we can do is to be all together in terms of our focus for developing our nation. The problem that has been is you will find like you may want to even sanction somebody and make sure they're relevant politically. But the team I belong with, Makali and you,
my community,
you and the two of you,
yes,
in the community are good to go, you fly. But I think it is critical that some of these things are exposed for purpose of people to know who is like standing against the reforms that we require to create in terms of the democratization process.
Let's look at the current discipline issues. A lot of parties are threatening members with
not elections.
Yeah,
giving returns to accounts. They're supposed to give accounts.
Yes.
What, how much money you raised? How much you spend? Yeah. You know, accounting.
Is that happening?
Yeah.
Although it's not well docket, but are you capacity building to make sure that they do returns and
establish?
Honestly, even as we are funded, the requirement of the law is that those are public funds and they must, there's no question about, they must be accounted for.
Yeah.
The problem is,
the Auditor General needs to look at the reports of political parties.
The overseer of this process is a register of political parties who has who has constitutional powers, but the problem is she is not capacitated to do that. And I think we persuade the president to do that quickly so that whoever does not do, we provide a list of shame.
That's what I'm saying. There is no political will to make strong parties. That's why Dongo stays acting.
In fact, the appointment of the successor to Ndungu flopped because the major players could not agree. Isn't that true, Magara?
Yeah. I mean, of course, in the political process,
Raila Kibaki could not agree to get a political.
Everybody will say that is not ours, and we want to present ours, and we can't have 10 registrars who are friendly to you. I think if we could manage to do other things bigger than they. Register political parties, this I think we must. In fact, sometimes people think like living in that vacuum is healthy to anybody.
Yeah.
It actually throws all of us into a spin. And I can tell you, however strong you think you want to be, those ones with undercurrents can also topple you without knowing. So it's only good that we respect institutions and be sure that we don't pull that person we want. I remember there was one time when we, in my other life politically, we said we want XYZ to be the chairman of IEBC.
Yes.
And when it didn't go our way, we said, no, we don't want him. We did a shoddy job that we also overhauled the entire IEBC.
Mm.
So we're saying sometimes we are pushed by emotions without logic, and then we do it as part of the moment. We bury the, just like you're tilling your land and leaving weeds behind you.
Mm.
So we're saying, I think when we do it right,
yeah,
it's for the benefit of all of us. Even those ones who think they're secure.
Yeah. So you preside over this college or gathering of political parties.
Mm-hmm.
All of them offenders of the law. They are not holding elections. They have interim officials. They don't have any intentions of holding of elections because they are looking at a short-term exit because they might be going to other political parties. What are you doing as CMD to get elections? Political parties to comply with their own constitutions.
When you register political parties, I take it back again to the appointment of register political parties. It is the register political parties who is a custodian of all the nomination rules, constitution of political parties.
Yes.
And you and me cannot know when so and so was supposed to do it. We deposit all this when you're registering with the register of political parties.
Yeah.
And even doing a matrix of who is supposed to do elections when and flag them in the media, it won't even help us. But again, what I'm doing is on acting capacity. Please understand where I'm coming from.
But even if she's acting capacity, she's worked.
She's working even as acting.
She's
on the job.
No, she's acting and she's working.
But the law is there. She's acting.
But remember,
and she's got a salary.
Okay.
Is all alone.
Let's leave that.
Two deputies and many other.
Okay, you cannot come and say yourself that, okay, we are helpers about it. That's not our business. We're not the prefects. this is a club. It has rules. You must have sanctions for membership. There's no discipline in this club. Anybody who has an MP, an MCA, has a president or a governor or a member of parliament can come here and we can all be in default of the law and that's okay and we go home and we are happy. CMD should have a mechanism for making sure that the members are actually disciplined, they're professional in their conduct, in their party affairs. Isn't that your concern?
All we're doing is to ensure that the auditor of political parties is doing their job and doing them right.
Yeah.
And I can tell you for sure, I signed a letter to the president about last week to persuade him to activate the process to make sure that the errant boys and girls are exposed.
Yeah, that is only persuasive, right? They have no mechanisms for
They have constitutional powers.
You as a CMD, you can only you can only peddle your influence because you say you're members here. We please do something about this.
Yeah, and again,
don't you think in the form of in terms of empowering yourselves, strengthening your mandate and your capacities, you would also need to get more teeth so that you actually require that for you to continue your membership in CMD, you must have certain house compliance rules that members need to comply with. Because if membership to a CMD is only by basis of having an elected this or that,
You know, also
really?
Bakali, CMD is governed by a trust, which trust brings out issues of integrity, good governance, and all the issues. If a member obviously is media for peddling drugs, we had a case like that, we need to deliberate and say, I think we cannot carry you on board with that kind of excess baggage. If until proved guilty, we are suspended.
Yeah.
That's our mandate. Yeah. Now, sanctioning legally, the members were eyeing in terms of elections, surely will be acting out of our mandate. Really.
Okay.
But we try to bring sanity. And again, if you start by exclusion, the essence of inter-party dialogue to solve issues will actually be lost. In fact, it is that form, that platform, that even those ones who have broken the law have agreed that we write a letter to the president.
Yes.
How is CMD funded?
CMD, we do it's a programmatic center where we have the major facilitator is NIMD, the Netherlands Institute for Multiparty Democracy of Netherlands. We also get support from the embassies, UN Women, the Ford Foundation, and they fund specific programs. Like as we speak now, we have a program headed by Ford Foundation, taking back to the counties and kind of enlightening the population on their role of public participation in terms of legislation and managing their own affairs. Because again, leadership, mamlaka kwa watu, at the machinali, we need them to kind of all town hall meetings to expose the members of public to know how they need to participate in their own governance. And that's one of the programs. We have a program with the Netherlands Embassy, the Dutch Embassy, dealing with sports. Because again, most youths are idle during between elections. We want to tell them beyond elections, you can do something and build yourself. And of course, if you find two teams, youths from this party getting together to play soccer, that helps. We do that at the constituency level. We also do from some sponsor. We are doing a program on political party dialogue. We also call members of political parties, bring them together, and tell them how do you communicate intra-party communication, so that we don't always be antagonistic in terms of engagement, so that the venom is reduced. We are antidote.
But when we attend these seminars, we find that most of the people who attend there are not even genuine party members.
They're not decision makers.
They're not decision makers. There are people who are in Nairobi or somewhere in the village or in the town who attend your meetings and pretending to be
representing the parties.
The impact of that is nil.
By whatever nature of composition, we are already imparting knowledge.
Yes.
Maybe the wrong people. But there are other cases and they are voters.
Impact assessment is necessary for CMD in terms of whether it's causing or it's executing its mandate and is having impact, and whether it needs to upscale, because you can't continue to operate at that level when the problems you're dealing with are magnified. They're bigger than the tools you're employing. Now we're talking about parties that have become rogue, they don't want whole elections, parties that are not respecting the ethics of democracy because they're threatening members who are defiant, you know, who don't have a party position, who are not wearing the party position, and the CMD is looking around. So how is that deepening democracy?
Of course. What I'm saying here is if you look at the impact assessment on part of like after 2007, I can tell you there were results. Also including participation of members of each political party expressing themselves. You know, where we're also lacking is where the discipline mechanism of political parties. Yeah. The law is also, we are trying to analyze that law of yes. a discipline of political members of political parties. It is still very cloudy. You know why? You are told to go back and clear with your political party before yeah. you bring to the arbitration tribunal.
Yes.
Now, surely, if the die is cast, there's yes. no way you're going to be cleared out there.
Yes.
That's an issue we also want to amend, because sometimes you're told to go to the disciplinary committee of a particular party, and there's no office where you can report your claim
yeah,
to.
Yeah.
So you find like people, that's a one way of holding you until you get tired. And
there's a rift that is brewing in a member party called UDF. Mm-hmm. Have you been seized of this matter?
Not at all, because until it affects a membership that who was representing that party in there,
yeah.
that is not our mandate.
Yeah.
But we do sympathize that, I mean, not sympathizing, but I think it's healthy that people are expressing themselves, regardless of who
yes.
thinks he owns the party.
Yeah.
So, from an outside position, I think it's a healthy engagement.
How is your own party doing, PDP? Are you all elections, or you are just, again, interim officials until you leave the party?
PDP is actually a party to watch. we rebranded yeah. that party either to before 2012 December.
Yes.
We had one member and about five MCAs.
Mm.
Which member again was errant because we could not pull the strings and hold them back
yes.
the party, because he went also cohabiting with a different party when he was a PDP member, courtesy of those looseness of engagement. And then when we rebranded in 2012, of course, we deposited our documents with the Register of Political Parties with amended constitution, and between 29th of October and end of Feb, we managed to scoop one governor, one MP, about 25 MCAs. That's a serious party. So we are re-engineering that party to be a party to watch in the next elections. I can tell you, we don't belong to the big names. We are mass movement of
you have one governor?
Yes.
Who is in trouble a lot?
He is not in trouble.
Yes.
He is now in intolerance again of people who have embraced democracy by word of mouth. Really. That gentleman is the most popular governor today. And if elections were to be called today, Obado will win this seat, you know.
Really?
I'm telling you. But what we saw in Migori is really an intolerance of alternative view.
Yeah.
Again, we are saying, we must disabuse our youth and our people from that kind of thinking, like, I must go to Mutegi's staff when he's holding my hand. Is that thing a primitive thing which you must all grow about? And it's regrettable it happens. It happened. And I've spoken about it again, not once. But
yeah.
what we're saying here is it does not matter. If surely you are not democratic in your own political party, don't pretend for 1 minute that you can rule the country democratically. So we are saying, open it up. Like PDP is a people's movement, and the slogan is Mamlaka kwa wananchi, the people power.
Mm.
That's about it.
So you intend to be growing it to the next election. We don't expect Omingo Magara has left PDP. Next, he's in for the people.
No,
or
no,
after
no.
that, he's in TNA.
No, no, no.
Yes.
Mobility, I think we are maturing as well. So as I said, we are growing PDP, and it's a party to watch in the next elections. And the sky is the limit.
Okay.
But the members of parliament, the constitution envisage that party hopping will stop.
Now, that's another problem. I'm telling you, I was not in parliament last time.
Yeah.
But I think, as I said, please let's make laws that are friendly to you when you have the instruments of power
and when
you're out of power. And let me give a classical example. One minister in the previous regime was told to reform the
prisons.
He refused.
Yes.
The second year he was in cells, so he asked, where do I sleep? He was told that mat there is where you're going to lie.
Yes. It's called
he never
tip
woke
tip.
Up from that time.
I've
forgotten his name.
Yes, yes. I remember him.
That he couldn't survive beyond that. Members of parliament, in terms of the laxity and feeling big and sweet,
yes.
they said we are moving the migration to the last minute. They never knew that last minute movement was only not exclusive to them, but anybody could move.
Mm.
Mutegi moved to Makali's staff the same time, and they all were able out.
Yeah.
So it is not always sweet when you think you have the leverage. The
yeah.
same thing can be like Musumeno. Musumeno cuts better than Yuma.
Mm.
That's what we do.
I know this is not your area, but when the Political Parties Act was passed, the requirement was that you should have membership to 20
yes.
counties.
Yes.
Political parties went to ATMs and all over the place and looked for documents and put P, including my name.
And buildings and took lists.
And then I belong to maybe one of political party which I didn't even apply. Are we going to see a repeat of that next 2017?
Well,
for them to qualify to be that.
We take that is one of the kind of conditions that are actually unconstitutional, because you don't have to, you must not be in 25 counties. The Bavarian party in Germany is a sectional thing, but it tilts the balance and neutralizes the balances of power. We are talking about a Green Party that is specific on environment. So that's unconstitutional. In fact, we are anticipating to take a constitutional reference that matter to the High Court. Because again, it's actually, it's like a capitalist now wanting to ensure that you do it. If you don't have the bread, again, it's also monetary. When those services are running, Mutegi, it must run with money. Yeah, so if Omingo does not belong to a big guy who has got briefcases and tons of money behind
so
him,
so we should not have restrictions on what
they
should
not be. Let me ask you, how do you expect people, there's some community, I think, is drop about 200,000, is it? How do you want them to be all over? And unless we have a kind of a members representation political party system, really a party list, those guys will never see power.
Yeah.
If you're benchmarking it on this kind of arrangement, how many you are, 5%?
All right, talking about
areas you cover.
Talking about the health of political party, I mean, there's a lot of feedback here for Omingo Magara, people making suggestions and all manner of things. And also we have the pleasure of having the Registrar of Political Parties, Lucy Ndungu, is online, and it's a pleasure to have her voice in this discussion. Registrar, how are our political parties? Perhaps we are being unfair to you.
No, they are not being unfair to me, and my name is Lucy Ndungu. What I wanted to clarify is that all political parties...
Is she online?
...came to clarify that political parties were reformed in 2012. They put in place a new their new constitutions, and in their new constitution, they specified that they have officials for a term of 5 years or 4 years. And it is in their constitution where they specified that they will carry out elections of their officials after their term were over. I do not have a single party which said that their officials were interim. All officials were told their position for a period of 4 or 5 years. The parties who are doing elections right now are rejuvenating themselves, like you rightfully said, or re-engineering themselves. But none of them has defaulted in carrying out their party elections. Number two, I wanted to clarify that political parties who do not have officials have specified structures which says that if Secretary General or Chairperson resigns or ceases to hold office, the deputy takes over. So we do not have a situation whereby you have a vacuum in the structures of political parties. However, we do know that it can take 2 or 3 weeks or 2 months for the neck to meet. And maybe that is the only situation where there can be a vacuum of an official. And Mr. Magara is very much aware that under a corporate entity, there isn't a single time when the entity does not have an official. Thank you.
But Ms. Ndungu, are you saying that all these political parties, as they stand at this point in time, are in compliance with the law?
I am saying that for the specific law of elections, official elections, they are in compliance. And those who are not in compliance may have started the elections and they have given us notice that they will do carry out elections. I have received 2 or 3 notices where they say that by the end of the year, they will carry out elections. Yet, they are just rejuvenating themselves. Otherwise, they have a period of 4 to 5 years for those officials who came on board after registration to remain in office.
What is the status with respect to the UDF? What is the dispute about? They have had an intention to change the officers. Attempt has been rejected by your office. What is the position?
And you heard them saying that they wanted to reblood. And it is at the initial stage of reblooding where these issues came on board, whereby the Secretary General and the chairman and the other officials did not agree. Otherwise, they are continuing with their process of reblooding themselves.
The rebranding had to do with the name. They wanted to change from UDF to Amani National Congress. You rejected the name Amani because it's an existing organization called Amani Coalition.
Amani is already a registered coalition with us in the year 2012, and they have not revoked the coalition yet. But you heard them saying they're in the process, maybe, of revoking the coalition. So we cannot register Amani as a name of a political party, when already in my record, we do have a Amani coalition.
What about ODM, which the elections and then the men in black came in? What is the status of ODM?
The status of ODM is that they also wanted to rebrand themselves, but they were caught up with Langos, which were not finalized at that particular time. They did write to me and told me, we are still in the process. They are talking, like you had, that you have to use political party internal mechanism to resolve disputes. And that is what they are doing. They wrote to me and told me the officials will be in office until they resolve the issue. I have that in writing.
Do they have a deadline?
Yes. They do not have a deadline because the deadline is dictated by their constitution, which says that officials will hold office for a period of time. All what they were trying to do was to rejuvenate themselves.
Okay, the step had been made of the previous officials stepping down or resigning in order to allow for the election to happen. And once that resignation is tendered, it was presumed that there are no officers. What has happened is that the all officers seem to be continuing to hold office. What is the record in your office?
The record in my office is that there were some officials who went in non-opposed. Those ones took position, and then they sat down and co-opted other officials to deal with internal party mechanism and address the issues which caught them up in the wrangles. It's just like a company. If the company has issues and you cannot imagine that you can have no directors in existence, somebody must take hold of the party and solve the internal wrangles until they carry out the elections.
All right, thank you so much, Madam Lucy Ndungu, the Registrar of Political Parties, there for joining us on that discussion. On the set of political parties this morning. We hope to have you in studio one of these days so we can look at the micro issues within those political parties. We are a long sought after guest on this show. Thank you for joining us though this morning. How back to you, Magara.
Yes.
You know, there are suggestions that to curb the migration of political parties and those haphazard, last minute, selfish amendments to the law to benefit the incumbents, changes need to be made blocking. The law needs to be secure from selfish manipulation. And this is the time.
Thank you.
What are you doing?
I attended an inter-sectoral committee which was looking at all the election laws which must be done when Makali before mid-2015. If they are not done, forget about them. The problem here is the chick and the egg.
Yes.
You are telling members of parliament to lock themselves out in whatever they perceive to be some paradise of their own. We are saying if the laws could be made and insulate them from changes a year or two before elections, this is the time. We made our representation to that commission, which was set up by the Attorney General under the Secretary of Justice and the Justice Secretary or under the Attorney General's office to propose amendments. In fact, we were supposed to be called about in a month ago. That meeting has not come. But we meant proposals and told the AG what sections must be done. It was all of us, the government was represented, political party were represented, and the civil society to suggest the laws that need to be amended now. And we said, until if they're not amended by 2015 mid, August, we can even forget about it. Because 2016, people will be actually on electioneering mode.
Yes, yes.
And it will be selfish for them to amend it to fit their own interests. So there are several laws, including, again, as I said, that migration, which is actually, in my thinking, not right. And we're saying, today, if you worked well, and you scanner some seats, most seats, you can easily reward your members in terms of nomination, because MCAs are there. And it's not that people, we're also impatient. So what we're saying is the law should be amended now, latest August 2015. Beyond that, we can say we're going to be the status quo.
Is CMD coming up with any proposals to, beef up this law? I mean, you see, I keep coming back to you because you are the neutral body in this political arena. There's no other.
By
I
the
mean,
way,
forum for political parties to think together and act together
I have told
without
you
being selfish.
We have made those proposals, very objective, consultative within our membership, and they're all agreed. Now, it is now on from the part of AG to draft those laws and present them to Parliament. In fact, we also made an appointment to see the Minister, the Committee on Justice and Administrative Affairs of the National Assembly.
Yeah.
We haven't we saw that appointment, we want to coordinate, because we also need to start lobbying beyond ourselves.
Yes.
So that when it comes, tell them it's in their interest also to do it, because they may also be shaped the same way.
Yeah. But when you say we, and you're talking about the members, the 40, the 29 plus,
yes.
plus one.
Yes, yes, those are members we're talking
for
about.
For a member.
Yeah.
So if you're all agreed, and that I'm talking about TNA, URP, ODM, ETC, PDP,
mm-hmm.
You know. So why are you not moving it?
We have moved it already.
Mm.
Again, in terms of drafting and seeing light of day,
yes.
our ends, our ends in recommendations.
All right.
Really. And
okay.
For them to be put on pen and paper
okay.
is the role of the Attorney right. General and maybe even the Committee
yes.
of on Administrative Justice and Legal Affairs, because they can also draft laws today.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Committee members, chairmen can do that, the chairman can do the law.
Yeah. We're coming to the end of our show, but you know, as part of still trying to see build consensus and bridges between political parties on the matter of the referendum.
Mm.
What did you say you're looking forward to, or anything happening to build inter-party dialogue around that matter?
Thank you. Magali, I said earlier that we offered ourselves that we can be a neutral arbiter. We nobody has sought our support, but we're now going reaching out to the factions. We soon, as I said, we're going to have separate sectoral meetings with the three proponents of a referendum process, and then we agree for them to give us maybe about 3-4 members to put acts together. Because even if you are going to a referendum or no referendum, we can't do 3 referendums, honestly. And you see, everybody else wants it. And you can see, in every respect, there are issues to be addressed, right?
Yes.
But as I said, if it's Omingo propelling it,
yes.
Maka doesn't like me, I'll oppose you.
Yes, yes.
Or if I think I want to delay your process, Muteki will throw in a spanner in the works.
Yes.
So it will be just like chasing our own tail if we do not realize that we need to detach ourselves from vested interest and look at what affects the Kenyans, consult them, and bring your views, we amalgamate them. CMD could be a solution to this, and we can have maybe only one referendum question.
Yeah.
But what worries me, my brothers, is that when we say we want to reduce the cost of living, I am looking at any amendment of the law. I mean, that's not something you can take to the people, because there is no clause you'll amend to reduce it. It is the environment and leadership, accountability and governance that brings us those kind of goodies.
Yes.
So.
Well,
sometimes let me be honest with you. Sometimes we say it to whip the emotions of people. But in reality, that question will never come to say, amend clause X to reduce cost of living to this amount.
Right.
I'm telling you frankly. And some of this, if you came on the table and tell them, brothers, we must be honest to Kenyans, and tell them what we believe in it,
yeah.
and some of us have issues with the Constitution for sure.
Yeah.
We knew that there are 20% to be done. How to be done? We need to do it with a Kenyan person in mind,
so
not a Makali,
that is,
you're not
talking
Omingo.
About dialogue. Why isn't that dialogue happening?
You know, if I call you to my house and tell you, Makali, you speak to me or else, even if I'm the weakest person, I'll develop some withdrawal syndrome. Seriously. And we're saying, respect me and I give you mutual respect.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. And if we open up ourselves honestly, there are issues to be addressed in the referendum, which can be done if we all meant well.
Yes.
But as I say, if I want to delay Makali, I'll throw my own one.
Yeah.
In fact, don't be surprised. There will be another one coming for another amendment. And let me tell you also,
yeah.
brothers, you must help this country. Because the enemies of devolution are still here. They don't like it. If you open that Pandora's box, nothing stops me from saying I don't like devolution and therefore reduce the governors to 5. Or I don't like the women reps. And that's my right.
Yes.
We
yeah,
shall be negating the gains that we have attained.
Yes.
I'm going to tell you. So when we are throwing it back to the people,
yeah.
it cannot you cannot control it. Just like when you pull a trigger, you cannot retrieve the bullet when it goes. It will have gone.
Yeah.
So before we let it go, can we package it?
Right.
Put a target right. And Kenya will be the best country. The only problem is, it's about me and my relevance. And my point, as opposed to Mutegi. I mean, really.
Okay.
It is a saying that I keep giving to my brothers who mean love, and the Bible says. It was two boys, twins, who were given food to eat, and they were given a long spoon. each boy want to eat himself. And they, every time they try to scoop the food was going to waste. What happened? The uncle told them, you are crazy fellows. You die with anger. What you do, scoop, feed your brother, and brother will feed you. That's the love we don't have, love in this country. We are too selfish ourselves.
Well, that's love that is totally lacking in the political arena. I mean we hope that we can have that love of meeting, discussing, sorting things out without having battles that go legal or referendum way. That's Omingo Magara, the chairman of the Center for Multiparty Democracy, which brings together all the political parties that qualify. And the ones that qualify are only 29, which are under his arms. So we hope that they can do much to establish and deepen our democracy. Thank you for watching Power Breakfast.